So in the first time in history, the WPT has finally come to Taiwan. They tried in the past a couple times, actually. The most recent time was supposed to be back in last March, but the pandemic changed things. But this time they made it here and was hosted at none other than CTP in Taipei. So I recently jumped in their WPT DeepStacks Main Event. The buy-in was 15,000 Taiwan dollars, which is about 500 USD. There ended up being over 500 entries, and the total prize pool was about 240K, with just over 45K up top. I was pretty happy to be able to play in a live WPT event all the way over here in Taiwan. It was also super cool to see the poker community over here growing at this rate. All right, so I thought I'd have a little fun doing an actual poker vlog of a session with some recorded hands with whole cards and all. Something that I've never done before and never thought that I'd ever do. So let's see how this goes. I arrive and sit down at level 4 with the big blind at 200. A few orbits in, I pick up kings in middle position and someone limps in front of me. I raise it to 1K. A guy behind me calls and the limper calls. Flop comes ace-queen-three rainbow. It checks to me and I bet 800. The guy behind quickly folds and the limper calls. At this point, given the action, I think I could probably represent quite credibly all the strongest hands on this board. But I had no info on the guy and it was really early in the tournament still. And I remember thinking that I was likely gonna have to invest a large number of chips to try to make him fold an unapproved ace by the river. If that's what he had. It seemed a little bit too reckless and unnecessary at this point. Combined with the chance that I was still winning, I decided to just check it through after he checks to me on the turn. He checks again on the river, and I check it through as well, and he turns over ace eight of clubs. Sometimes when you don't have any info on your opponent and you don't know how he thinks about hands, you just have to kind of play your hands straightforwardly. One thing I see often is when a player is trying to make decisions according to theory, but the guy that he's playing against doesn't know that or doesn't care and is just playing his hand. The first player ends up sometimes just making a big play at the pot, you know, dumps all his chips where he just has no chance of getting it through. Next hand, I pick up 7-8 of spades in middle position. I make it 600 and a guy behind me reaches for his chips and looks like he's about to 3-bet. He ends up just calling. The guy in the blind also calls. I flop the open-ender on 5-6-3, one spade, and throw out 1300. The guy behind me calls it, and the guy in the big blind folds. The turn comes a queen, and I'm definitely gonna have to keep betting here. I make a larger bet of 4K, and he tanks for a long time. He really wanted to call here and probably felt like he should continue a lot, but he ends up folding it and flashes me his hand, actually, and he had jacks. I really didn't think he was that strong. I don't blame him for folding the turn. You know, I think he's beating a lot of drawing hands that I could still have that I would play this way. But I guess if he calls here, he is probably just calling the turn to hope that I don't bet the river. And I guess even given his position, he'd be put in a tough spot. So either way, I was pretty happy when he finally let it go and was definitely lucky that he decided to fold here. Next up, I get ace deuce of hearts in early position and raise to 600, and I get called in three spots. A guy behind me plus the two blinds. The flop comes deuce 5-9 rainbow with one heart. It checks to me and I bet 1300. It folds to the last guy in the big blind. He thinks about it for a bit and then he calls. Turn comes the seven of diamonds and he checks and I check it. The river comes the ace of spades, giving me aces up, and he checks again. I decide to go for 3200 here, and he decides to check raise me to 9000. I was thinking he could be playing all the better aces up hands like this, but at the same time, he might possibly have some of the smaller two pair hands that he made from calling from the blinds as well. Before this hand happened, when I first sat down, I heard him talking to his poker buddy across the table about poker strategies, and just from listening to what he was saying, it was quite apparent to me that he was a player who was putting quite a bit of thought into whatever play he was making, and definitely was not necessarily going to be playing his hands that straightforwardly. And I don't think I was going to be folding anyways, but I think this definitely did help my decision here. So I throw in the chips and he nods and turns over six deuce of spades. So after seeing his specific hand here, I think it's a good spot to raise too. Holding the six and the deuce. I might have done the same thing, you know, in his shoes, the way the hand played out. The guy then asked me if I would have folded if I just had the bare ace. I think if I just had the ace here, it's gonna feel like a much tougher call, even though in my opinion, it doesn't really change that much. What I mean is that if he's choosing to turn a hand to a bluff here, whether I have aces up or just a big ace, it doesn't really matter since most of his good hands that he's gonna choose to raise on the river are usually gonna be better than mine anyways. So for the next few levels, I put off some valuable chips, making some unsuccessful steal attempts. But at level 9 is where I lose a key all-in hand. The big blind is now at 800 and I get dealt 6s on the button. Three players limp in front of me and I make the call, and then the small blind also calls. And then now the big blind just decides to stick it in. He had about 12k and some change, and it didn't even look like he looked at his hand when he went all in. I mean, I guess he could sometimes just put it in blind here with his stack size and give him the action. So they all fold to me, and with the added dead money from the limps, I was expecting him to be pretty wide here. So I thought I could go either way here, but you know, I couldn't resist, so I tossed in the chips and was okay actually to see that we were still flipping when he turns over queen nine suited. But unfortunately, he flops the nuts. For the next couple levels, I end up losing even more of my stack, picking up just decent hands like king, queen suited, but then the board just comes out the complete opposite end of the spectrum. I get to level 11, the big blind is now at 1200, and I get ace, king in the cutoff. So there's an open raise in front of me to 2500 and one caller in front of me. Raise to 7500, and the initial raiser doesn't waste too much time and decides to stick it in. The guy between folds, and I calculated that it was about 30 big blinds to call it off here. This is another one of those spots in a tournament where I feel like I'm pretty happy to just call it off without much thought, but since he had me fully covered, I wasn't going to be that thrilled if this was just going to be a flip for my tournament, and it's probably going to be up here most of the times, I think. At least some of the times he's going to have the same hand, and folding still just seemed ridiculous, so I called it off pretty quickly, and he turns over jacks. And the jack comes right on the flop, giving me no chance to improve, and that was it. I was out. I guess it's pretty normal for all of us to later think what if this and what if that. And I think the what if moment for me about this hand was that if I had just won the flip with the sixes earlier, my stack size would have been much different, and it probably wouldn't have gotten all in before the flop here, and things would have played out differently. But you know, that's how it goes. It was fun while it lasted.